it is still the jewel in the crown because it's been there since 1929. It's had almost all of the great drivers win at Monaco.
No, but Monaco was very special. I loved Monaco because it was more an intuitive driving, like if you were driving a rally or so, because you go through the streets of Monaco with you look at the road, you feel how close you are to the guardrail, and sometimes when you just glance it, but you know it didn't do any damage that you knew, and so on. So, and it was terrific driving. I really liked it.
I think Monaco being a street circuit, narrow, you know, as bigger other cars, is more difficult to drive in Monaco. And the history, the glory of Monaco as, I would say, the number one Grand Prix in the world. Yeah. Yes.
It was exhilarating. It was incredible. You go, you know, you blast out of that corner, is it Portier? And then you go through the tunnel and you come down into the chicane, you haul on the brakes, you really feel the deceleration there. And then the whole swimming pool section, your heart is in your mouth. You just, you know, just concentrating on getting everything precise. But, or, you know, keeps the attention, I can tell you that.
And I remember, like if it was yesterday actually, that I went to knock on Ayrton Senna's bus to see if he could just give me a little lead on what to do. And he said, you're gonna hear a lot of the guardrails and the noise, don't worry, that's fairly normal. I remember that, and it's amazing because it's bang, bang, you just hear the bang on the rails.